hours after Trump promised major action on opioid epidemic, he takes down Pharma CEO in massive raid. The opioid epidemic has been sweeping the nation and has left thousands of people dead in its wake. Which is exactly why President Trump declared a national crisis over it. One of the biggest parts of this crisis is physician-prescribed opioids, which leads to opioid abuse. Doctors are prescribing unnecessary opioids and patients are becoming addicted. President Trump said the following about declaring this issue a national crisis. "We owe it to our children and to our country to do everything in our power to address this national shame and human tragedy." Right after the national crisis was declared, CEO John Kapoor was arrested by agents of the federal government for bribing doctors to prescribe highly addictive opioid pain medication. His formal complaint alleges he worked to collude and bribe people in power to prescribe Subsys, which is a fentanyl spray for cancer patients with the highest levels of pain. He now faces several felony charges. Some of them include RICO conspiracy charges, conspiracy to commit mail and wire fraud, and conspiracy to violate the anti-kickback law. As well, he is facing decades behind bars and millions of dollars in fines if convicted. Acting United States Attorney William D. Weinrib said, "In the midst of a nationwide opioid epidemic that has reached crisis proportions, Mr. Kapoor and his company stand accused of bribing doctors to overprescribe a potent opioid and committing fraud on insurance companies solely for profit. We must hold the industry and its leadership accountable just as we would the cartels or a street-level drug dealer." 20. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. The opioid epidemic has been sweeping the nation and has left thousands of people dead in its wake. Which is exactly why President Trump declared a national crisis over it. One of the biggest parts of this crisis is physician-prescribed opioids, which leads to opioid abuse. Doctors are prescribing unnecessary opioids and patients are becoming addicted. President Trump said the following about declaring this issue a national crisis. "We owe it to our children and to our country to do everything in our power to address this national shame and human tragedy." Right after the national crisis was declared, CEO John Kapoor was arrested by agents of the federal government for bribing doctors to prescribe highly addictive opioid pain medication. His formal complaint alleges he worked to collude and bribe people in power to prescribe Subsys, which is a fentanyl spray for cancer patients with the highest levels of pain. He now faces several felony charges. Some of them include RICO conspiracy charges, conspiracy to commit mail and wire fraud, and conspiracy to violate the anti-kickback law. As well, he is facing decades behind bars and millions of dollars in fines if convicted. Acting United States Attorney William D. Weinrib said, "In the midst of a nationwide opioid epidemic that has reached crisis proportions, Mr. Kapoor and his company stand accused of bribing doctors to overprescribe a potent opioid and committing fraud on insurance companies solely for profit. We must hold the industry and its leadership accountable just as we would the cartels or a street-level drug dealer." Kapoor's arrest gives credence to the theory that doctors are not operating responsibly but instead are in the pockets of pharmaceutical companies. Which means they are endangering the lives of their patients in order to make more and more money. The charges also allege that Kapoor, along with others, attempted to defraud and mislead insurance providers so as to get them to approve payment for lethal drugs that were prescribed to non-cancer patients despite the pills being for those who had cancer. Bail has been set for Kapoor by a judge for $1 million. He was also forced to surrender his passport, under the contingency that he could not travel internationally, as well as submit to electronic monitoring. When he appeared in court, he came in with basketball shorts, tennis shoes, and a sloppy t-shirt. His attorneys have not been successful thus far in getting him lower bail. Attorney Brian T. Kelly from Boston was the lawyer for renowned mobster Whitey Bulger of Boston, Massachusetts, and is now defending Kapoor. Time wrote, "Kapoor came to the U.S. from India to get his Ph.D. in medicinal chemistry from the University of Buffalo, where the pharmacy school is named for him and his wife to honor their longtime philanthropy. Kapoor, whose worth Forbes estimated at $1.75 billion, also founded a company that operates 7 restaurants, including the Japanese eatery Roka Acker in Scottsdale. In Massachusetts, former Incy's CEO Michael L. Babbage and 5 other former executives and managers are set to go to trial in October 2018 and have pleaded not guilty. The latest indictment brings new charges against Babbage and others. Several former Incy's employees and healthcare providers have pleaded guilty to felony charges around the country, including in Alabama and Connecticut. A Rhode Island doctor pleaded guilty Wednesday to accepting kickbacks in return for prescribing the highly addictive fentanyl spray. A spokesman for Arizona-based Incy's said this week that the company is under new management and has replaced nearly all its original sales staff. It says it takes responsibility for the actions of its former employees. "We have taken necessary and appropriate steps to prevent past mistakes from happening in the future, and are committed to conducting business according to high ethical standards in the interests of patients," the company said in a statement Wednesday. "We also continue to work with relevant authorities to resolve issues related to the misdeeds of former employees." Senator Claire McCaskill of Missouri said evidence from a congressional probe she launched this year suggested that Incy's had gotten away with fines that amounted to a slap on the wrist for actions that helped fuel a nationwide epidemic that has claimed hundreds of thousands of American lives. Kapoor was named the drug maker as president and CEO in November 2015 after Babbage resigned without explanation. Federal authorities apparently have been investigating the company for some time. In late 2013, Incy's said it received a subpoena from the Department of Health and Human Services asking for documents tied to the commercialization of Subsys. Nearly a year later, it received a subpoena from U.S. prosecutors in Boston for documents connected with sales and marketing practices for the drug. In addition to the criminal charges, states have been suing Incy's over its marketing practices. Meanwhile, the company has been active in politics, donating $500,000 last year to an Arizona campaign to defeat a ballot measure to legalize marijuana. The company's stock price has taken a big tumble in recent months amid the legal issues. Incy's stock plunged more than 20% Thursday. Both urban and rural parts of the United States have been hit by this pandemic. Grandparents have had to become primary caregivers for their grandchildren because of the drug abuse of their children. It has drained local resources as well as federal resources, leaving both the local and federal government at a loss over what they need to do.